I will talk a bit about improving the quality of LibreOffice source code and what we do more or less each day to make sure that despite having something of about 2,000 commits a month, the quality is acceptable. So I will talk mostly about the first two topics, our main areas at the moment, and then just branch out into some other simple stuff that we do during the normal process. So we use Coverity. We have a custom setup for making sure that we don't crash during import and export. Coverity is a static code analyzer for C, C++, Java, that's developed by an American company. It was developed as part of a government program. It provides a free service to open source projects. It creates web-based reports for these open source projects. The project can give the right to view these reports to people, and they can then fix the reports. It's used by many open source projects like the Linux kernel, Mozilla, LibreOffice, and for a static code analyzer, the results are quite good. So it finds real issues and not just some unused code or something like that. So how do we look at the moment? That's taken about an hour ago from the Coverity website. You can see the last analyzed was yesterday. Our defect density, that means we have two defects in about 100,000 lines of code. We were actually at zero until a week ago when we changed the tool chain to a more modern version that detects a bit more. As you can see here, compared to the last build, 86 have been eliminated and just 78 have been added because Graylin fixed something like 20 or 30. Since we started with it, we have fixed about 12,000 reports. At the moment, we have 100 outstanding, but most of them are already fixed in master. So we have one hero that's fixing most of them. Some more charts. You can see here in December, we reached for the first time zero outstanding defects. And since we really started to look at it in January 2014, we made some really nice progress and fixed some serious issues. So the people who did the work, you notice Graylin has about 10 times as many fixes as Norbert, the next guy. Graylin is a machine. He is working like three people. Just when the new ones come in, he just fixes them. You see that there are 35 of the 100 open that he already fixed again. So crash testing, that's a more abstract idea. We want to find documents that cause problems automatically. So long before we ship our product, we want to know, okay, we have introduced a problem that causes problems for our users. We are mostly concerned about crashes during import because they might contain security issues, but also crashes during export, validation errors, so ODF validation errors, OXML validation errors, and for that we use a debugutil build. That's a special build that changes the standard template library to the debug version for and that adds checks like running out of the memory for a container and stuff like that, invalid iterators. And it enables all our asserts. So we have now, I think, a bit more than 4,000 asserts in our code base. If we hit one during import, export, it will automatically result in a report that we get. the setup is quite complex. It's several levels of Python and shell scripts to catch when we crash, to not crash our script that's running the crash testing. And we are currently running it on something like 76,000 Baxilla documents. For that, we have a 64-core server at the moment that's taking about 1 day to go through all the documents. We do the same with Address Sanitizer from time to time, which finds even more serious issues like buffer overflows, stack overflows. That has been added with the new server, as before it was just impossible to run it. It takes about 5 days on the new server, and with my old setup I needed already 5 to 6 days for the 76,000 documents. So let's have a look at our numbers. Please note that it's a logarithmic scale. So we started with a lot of simple crashes that we quickly fixed. And now we are here at, I think, 20 import crashes that are most of the time just asserts. So they are not like really problems where we do something really stupid. It's just like we check something and say, okay, something is wrong, crash in our debug utility. And it's not just 76,000 normal documents. It's really Baxilla documents. It contains documents that come from fuzzers, some non-public security-related documents, and still we managed to improve our quality quite a lot in the last, I think that's 2 years ago. Then for the export, it's not that good yet, but we made some progress. It's not a logarithmic scale. You see, sometimes we have some spikes where we added something stupid and then immediately realized, okay, something happened, and go back more or less to the old code. We are here now at about 700, but you need to notice that we import 76,000 documents and we export about, I think, 150,000 documents. 76,000 documents imported, around 150,000 at the moment exported, and we generate about 180 gigabytes of files. It takes a bit more than a day at the moment. Most of the time is actually spent in the validation of the documents, and not anymore in the import or export. We use ODF Validator for the ODF documents and Office Otron for the OXML documents. So there are a few other things that we do to make sure that our quality is good. There's CPP check. It's an open source static analyzer. It's not as good as Coverity. It finds mostly stylistic problems that you can reduce the scope of a variable, C-style casts, unread variables, redundant assignments, no copy constructor. It's fixed mostly as part of easy hacks, so entry-level tasks. They are really simple. You can get used to building LibreOffice. They are reported on one of our websites and updated regularly through a virtual machine. We have quite a few people that write Clang plugins that are special trackers that work on the abstract syntax tree and find common errors that we notice that are shared across the whole code base and not limited to a small piece of code. They are run on a few tinderboxes and by Stefan Bergmann, who is one of the guys implementing them, and Noel Kretter. Simple examples are that our string class is passed by value instead of by const reference. Missing sal override, which expands to a C++ C++ override if it's available on your platform, but also really stupid stuff like if a variable is translated to Boolean, like an integer, implicitly instead of explicitly, which might indicate a coding error. Then we started with buffering. It's mostly done for external filters, so the Document Liberation project uses it quite a lot, which also LibreOffice uses these filters for some formats. The plan is to run it together with our crash testing, an address sanitizer, maybe memory sanitizer. I mentioned address sanitizer already a few times. We use, or a few of us use that regularly. It's used as part of the crash testing every few weeks. It's developed by Google. It's a quite nice project. It's similar to Wallkind, but it's much faster. It's like one magnitude faster than Wallkind. Of course, address sanitizer, for example, only detects some of the errors that Wallkind finds, but some of the errors that it finds are not detected by Wallkind. We normally use a quite new version of Clang for that. So I, for example, built normally a trunk. It's supported in newer GCC versions, so you might have luck there. But I think nobody of us uses the GCC implementation. It finds, for example, leak sanitizer, quite a few really nasty leaks that we already fixed. Like if you created an array formula in Calc for a huge range, for each cell we were leaking something like 100 bytes. And if you use it on a really big range, you could easily leak a few hundred megabytes by updating the formula over and over again. Upsan for undefined behavior, quite a lot of work from Stefan Bergmann recently went into it, like invalid shifts, dividing by zero, and yeah, quite a lot of that was also in external libraries where he patched them and upstream his patches. Address sanitizer for buffer overflows, stack overflows, which is quite helpful and prevents quite a lot of issues long before we reach even a user or even the testing of a beta build or something like that. I think that's our most important ones. I think I missed a few, but yeah. I hope that at least that gives an idea of what we are doing to keep our quality and or even improve it in the future.